Hello students and welcome back to bankexamstudy.com. So today I'm going to provide you 11 important questions for the financial awareness section for IBPS RRB scale 2 GBO, and it is also useful for the other scale 2 level exams, scale 2 and scale 3 level exams, right? So my name is Ramandeep Singh and I request all of you to install bankexamstudy's mobile application. I have uploaded a lot of study material for the GBO exam. So the first one, RBI has removed the transaction charges. This is in itself a really important point. RBI has removed the transactional charges levied by it for which of the two systems to boost the digital transaction. RTGS and NEFT charges has been removed by the RBI. That's really important. So RBI has removed it. So very important. So Facebook has launched a cryptocurrency. Not commercially available, but it has launched it. The name of that particular currency, what is the name of that cryptocurrency launched by the Facebook? That is the name of that currency is Libra. Libra is the name of that cryptocurrency. Just like Bitcoin, there will be Libra. The RBI has launched on its website for facilitating grievance redressal process. So a new RBI has launched a new complaint management system, so that a customer can file a complaint against an entity which is monitored by RBI. So it is a software application launched by the RBI for lodging the complaints against any regulated entity. That includes any bank or any NBFC, urban cooperative bank. That's it. So which country has become the first Arab country to be granted the full membership of Financial Action Task Force? So first of all, what is the purpose of Financial Action Task Force? So it is an international group responsible for issuing international standards, policies, best practices for combating the money laundering and terrorist financing. Proliferation. So basically to tackle the money laundering and terrorist financing, this organization was actually started in 1989 with the headquarters in Paris. So there are 37 members. Okay, so this one, so which Arab country, so this is Saudi Arabia, became the first member of Financial Action Task Force. So which bank, really important, this is a star question. You are going to find this question, this particular question in the exam, the merger wala point. Which bank and Bharat Financial Inclusion Limited announced the merger will be, and this merger will be effective from 4th of July 2019. So kaun se bank or the NBFC merge hone wali hai? So Bharat Financial Inclusion is going to be merged with IndusInd Bank. So IndusInd Bank and Bharat Financial Inclusion Limited, they are going to be merged. Okay. So CCI, the Competition Commission of India, has approved the merger of the India Bulls Housing Finance with which bank? India Bulls Housing Finance with Lakshmi Vilas Bank. So merging to an NBFC and a bank, it has its own advantages. So NBFCs, they are facing the liquidity crunch. They are not getting the finance because of the IL&FS crisis. So bank is going to provide them the finance if it is merged. And then the NBFC is going to provide its customer base and high quality assets to the bank. So it is a win-win situation for both. So India Bulls Housing Finance is going to be merged with the Lakshmi Vilas Bank. So GST Day is going to be celebrated on 1st of July, because on 1st of July 2017, I think it was implemented. Okay. So it was implemented on 1st of July. That's why the GST Day is celebrated on 1st of July. So Union Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation launched in a bid to effectively track India's progress on Agenda 2030 adopted by UN. So what is SDG? Basically, what is SDG? So that was a universal call by the UNDP, United Nation Development Program. United Nation Development Program for action towards a poverty removal, improvement of health and education, and then the protection of planet. So that was the goal of SDG, right? So India, actually we made a dashboard. So in that dashboard, in the SDG dashboard, there will be the data from a lot of, you know, there will be a data from a lot of, you know, there will be data, 100 different data sets from a lot of mobile apps, the government apps. So the correct answer, the 8th ka correct answer is Sustainable Development Goal Dashboard. Sustainable Development, SDG ka full form is Sustainable Development Goal. So Sustainable Development Goal Dashboard is that name of the dashboard. Okay. So which state government recently approved an amendment to Factories Act 1948? So first of all, you should know a Factory Act is actually, you know, is it is applicable to establishments in which 10 or more workers are working, where electricity is used, and in 20 or more workers where electricity is not used, right? So it is implemented there. Up till now, it was not allowed to hire the women in the night shift, but now it is allowed in one state. Which state we are talking about? So we are talking about Goa. In Goa, the women, they are allowed to work in night shifts. Okay. So who will take the charge of MD of National Housing Bank? So who will take the charge of National Housing Bank? Sarada Kumar Hota. Okay, Sarada Kumar Hota, he'll be the new MD. So who has introduced enhanced disclosure guidelines for credit rating agencies? Obviously it's SEBI, but you should know the little in-depth about knowledge about it. So SEBI has asked the rating companies to disclose, this one is important, the probability of default of the issuer rate. So they need to make a benchmark and they need to disclose that what is the probability that a particular issuer of a commercial paper, he'll default the payments. So he'll default it. After the ILFS case, many, even the liquid funds, even many of the liquid funds, they defaulted. I mean, they went down by 7-8%, notably Taurus and the principal liquid funds that I'm talking about. So the credit rating agencies, while they are rating the commercial papers or any you know, debt instrument, they need to mention this, right? So that's the only thing I think that's important. They need to disclose the probability of the default. Okay, so that's all for today, students. In case you are looking for IBPS RRB scale 2 complete course for the marketing officer, for agriculture officer, and for the scale 3, if you are looking for the complete course including the video classes, notes, test series, and the quizzes, install the Bank Exams Today mobile app or go to learn.bankexamstoday.com. 9072-01000, that's my WhatsApp number, where you can drop a message anytime and I'm going to reply you. So this is the list of IBPS SO marketing officer successful students, the students who joined our courses and who actually successfully cracked the exams. SEBI grade A, NABARD grade A, Vijaya Bank credit officer, Bank of India credit officer. This is a list of students who cracked and finally got the job in the recent exam. So that's all for today, students. Thank you and have a very nice day. Bye.